کشنا.
هری کشنا.
هری کشنا مارج.
هری کشنا.
جشن
خواب یه
بانی.
جشن خواب. دیگ بانی ما. دیگ بانی.
اوکی.
من جنبی ها. حبه اومد به حالا. ام نما بگبته وسو دیفایا.
Om namo
bhagavate
vasudevaya.
Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya. Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya.
So we're telling about Gop Kumar, a cowherd boy from Govardhan, how he's using his mantra to travel in the universe. And he went to Brahmaloka. And he ended up becoming Lord Brahma. He got the position of Lord Brahma. So while he was Lord Brahma, he was hearing from some of the people who live there in Brahmaloka, like the personified Vedas. They were telling him about the glories of devotional service. They told him that liberation is insignificant for a devotee.
对于奉献者而言,
they told him there's very, very small amount of happiness in liberation.
他们告诉他,就是在解从解脱,只有非常少量的快乐而言,
but there's an ocean of unlimited happiness which is ever increasing in devotional service.
然而,在奉献服务当中,是有无穷无尽的,不断增加的,如海洋一般的快乐。
So, the personified Vedas, they're telling him that the happiness in simply meeting or seeing the Lord is nothing compared to the happiness of serving the Lord.
维达金的人格化身也告诉他,亲眼见到主和遇见主,相比服务主来说,也不如服务主得到的快乐大。
We have to understand that the process which we're practicing is service to Lord Krishna. And that service to Lord Krishna, that is also the goal of the process. Just like we say chant Hare Krishna, chanting Hare Krishna is the means, it's the process, and it's also the goal. So, for the impersonalist, this is very difficult to understand. Impersonalists, they only know how to get free of how to stop pain, how to stop the suffering of the material world.
非人格主义者一心只想着怎么停止物质存在的痛苦。
But they don't know about real happiness, which comes in service to the Lord.
但是他们并不了解服务主能够得到多少真实的快乐。
So, one who often people practice spiritual life, they only think about knowledge and renunciation.
通常而言，那些进行灵修的人只知道知识和培养知识，以及要弃绝。
Or they want some kind of material success. Their goal is to get some kind of material success.
或者他们就觉得他们的目标是取得物质上的成就。
But for a devotee, devotee simply wants service to Krishna, and it depends on Krishna's mercy.
奉信者们却一心只想服务 Krishna， 并且同时他们是依赖着 Krishna 的。
So, the Vedas, the personified Vedas, they're telling that devotees are not interested in just getting knowledge or enjoying the results of work or renouncing.
Veda 经的人格化身还告诉他，奉献者们对于培养知识
material life.We get good, we earn good karma.
当我们在物质生活当中履行固定的职责的时候，会给自己赢得虔诚的 karma.
But a devotee doesn't want to enjoy good karma.
但奉献者他们并不想享受这些虔诚的功果。
Devotee just wants devotion to Krishna.
奉献者只想要。同样的，我们对于培养知识也无所谓。我们不想成为一个大学者，我们只想对 Krishna 做出奉爱。
And we don't care about being renounced, about giving up everything from the material world.
我们也不在意弃绝，去放弃物质世界的一切。
We just want to be attached to Krishna and Krishna's service.
我们只想依附 Krishna， 依附对 Krishna 做服务。
So someone may say, well, Krishna is very kind to everyone. Why doesn't he give devotional service to everyone?
有人就会提出这样的疑问： Krishna 对每个人都那么仁慈，为什么他会把奉献服务给每一个人呢？
Well, the reason is they don't want devotional service. They want other things.
有的人就会说，为什么有的人得不到呢？答案是，有的人他不想要奉爱，他们想要别的。
Yeah, they want to enjoy some material results.
他们想要享受物质的功果。
Somebody else wants to get a lot of knowledge. Somebody else wants to be very renounced.
有的人就想要获得大量的知识，还有的人就想变得非常的气绝。
But devotee only wants Krishna's mercy.
奉献者却只想要 Krishna 的仁慈。
So he just goes on doing devotional service.
因此奉献者会持续不断地做奉爱服务。
And just waits for Krishna to give his mercy.
同时等待着 Krishna 赐予他仁慈。
So we have to take shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna.
所以我们应当托庇 Krishna 的莲花足。
The lotus feet of Krishna is where we can get the greatest ecstasy.
我们从 Krishna 的莲花足可以获得最了不起的快乐。
It's also the place where taking shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna is the goal of liberation.
托庇 Krishna Krishna 莲花族也是解脱的目标。
Liberation is not significant for the devotee.
对奉献者而言，解脱是微不足道的。
Liberation is at the feet of the devotee. Devotee can have it any time.
解脱就住在奉献者的莲花足下，奉献者随时随地的都可以获得解脱。
Bhakti is much greater than mukti.
Bhakti 要比 mukti 伟大的多。
Right. Mukti means liberation.
Mukti 就是解脱。
And Krishna is known as Mukunda, one who gives liberation.
Krishna 有个名字叫 Mukunda, 是赐予解脱的人。
Okay, so if we want to cultivate devotional service, we have to give up all these material desires.
如果人若想培养奉爱服务，必须要放弃一切的物质欲望。
If we still have desire in our heart to get something material, then we cannot get pure devotion.
倘若内心还依然存留着物质的动机的话，就无法获得纯粹的奉爱。
So a devotee should not worry about material thing. We shouldn't even worry about liberation.
所以我们不应该担心物质的事物，甚至不应该渴求解脱。
Then we become qualified for devotional service.
这样才有资格从事奉爱服务。
So devotional service means no material desires.
奉爱服务就意味着没有不掺杂一丝一毫的物质欲望。
Now we have duties, we have responsibilities in the material world. We have to do these duties.
我们有各自在物质世界的各自的职责，还必须得履行。
That helps us advance in devotional service.
这却可以帮助我们在奉爱服务当中取得进步。
We cannot give up the responsibilities which we have.
我们无法放弃各自的职责。
Lord Chaitanya was a sannyasi, but he was practicing pure devotional service.
主 Chaitanya 他是一个托钵僧 sannyasi, 但是他却修习着纯粹的奉爱。
So he never gave up his duty as a sannyasi.
他从未放弃身为 sannyasi 的职责。
If we give up our duties, then we have to be very pure in it. We have to be ready to give up everything.
倘若我们想要放弃各自的职责的话，必须要非常的纯粹，并且已经做好了准备。
We have to be fully dedicated to the service of Krishna.
全心全意的奉献给对主 Krishna 的奉爱服务。
And when we have the real taste for devotional service, then we don't have to worry about all the duties or responsibilities of the material life.
当我们发展了对奉爱服务的品味，就无需再担心在物质生活当中的职责。
But we should understand that's a very high level of devotional service.
但我们必须要明白，这个奉献服务当中是非常崇高的境界。
So, gradually we have to progress. Gradually we have to give up the material attachments.
我们要逐步的放弃在物质生活当中的依附，逐渐的一步一步的取得进步。
We don't need to worry. We should not worry so much about eating and sleeping and mating and defending.
我们无需 不需要去担心吃睡房位交配的问题。
We may be householders, but we should not be attached to the home.
我们可能身为居士，然而却不应该依恋家庭。
We shouldn't be attached to all the family members and all the wealth and everything.
我们不应该依附家人，也不应该依附各自的财产或者是别的。
And we shouldn't accumulate. We shouldn't have more than we actually need.
我们不应当积攒超过所需的财产。
So in this way, then we become ready for actual devotional service.
这样我们就为真正的奉献服务做好了准备了。
If we do different rituals, different duty rituals, which we think, well, I have to do this because of, I'm a householder, I have to do that, have this responsibility, then these kind of mundane rituals, they keep us in, they take us away from devotional service.
如果我们还念念不忘。就是仪式举行仪式因为我们有居士的这种职责，这样的这种世俗的观点就会把我们的奉爱拿走。
And if we try to renounce everything, then it also makes our heart very dry and hard.
倘若我们想要放弃一切的话，这种念头也会让我们的内心变得非常的枯燥和坚硬。
And it takes away, again, it will influence our taste for devotional service.
这种想法会影响我们在奉献服务当中的品味。
But we can also use these things in the service of Krishna.
我们却可以将它用来为 Krishna 做服务。
They don't have to harm our devotional service. We have to know how to use them in the service of Krishna.
他们不会，对我们的奉献服务造成伤害。我们只需要如何将他们用于为 Krishna 做服务。
So when we do proper devotional service, the result is.We'll get genuine devotion of Krishna.
如果我们从我们培养对 Krishna 的奉爱服务的话，结果就是能够培养起对 Krishna 的真正的奉爱之情。
We'll also get detachment from all these material things.
也会对所有的物质事物培养了真正的弃绝心。
And there will be direct experience of Krishna.
就会直接的体验到 Krishna.
Means we'll actually experience the pleasure of service.
意思就是说，我们能够从服务当中品尝到对 Krishna 的服务的快乐。
So we can.We can get this just simply by engaging in devotional service.
这一切都可以通过简单的从事奉爱服务而取得。
So devotee, sometimes we think about going to the heavenly planets, or sometimes we think about liberation. Sometimes we think about going back to Godhead. And Krishna can give us all these things very easily.
身为奉献者，有时候我们会想着去天堂，或者是想着获得解脱，甚至呢想着回归神手。但是 Krishna 可以轻而易举地把这一切都给我们。
But we have to get rid of our sinful reactions from the past, different activities we have which we performed before we became devotees. We have to get rid of the reactions.
我们必须要。放弃过往的所有的罪恶活动的反应，在我们成为奉献之前，必须要把这一切都放弃。
Because we've been in the material world a very long time, we've had many, many births in the material life.
因为我们在物质世界已经待的时间太久了，已经反反复复的无数次的投生。
So we have many sinful reactions.
因此呢，就是罪行累累。
And we have to get rid of these things. We do things like we do some charity, and we do some austerity, and we do some meditation.
我们必须要将所有的罪恶活动反应都消除殆尽。所以有的时候我们从事布施、苦行、冥想。
And these things help us to come to bhakti, to take up bhakti.
而这一切都有利于我们来接受 bhakti 奉爱。
So by the mercy of Krishna and the association of devotees, we learn how to take pleasure in the self.
通过 Krishna 的仁慈和与奉献者的联谊，我们学习从自我当中获得快乐。
And we're no longer attached to the impersonal, to that impersonal Brahman. It doesn't attract us.
而对不再依附于非人格的 Brahman, 这非人格的 Brahman 已经对我们没有什么吸引力了。
So sometimes people who are meditating on the impersonal, who are attached to the Brahman, to that impersonal feature, sometimes they also become attracted to devotional service.
有的时候就是依附于非人格 Brahman 的人也受到奉爱服务的吸引。
And then by the mercy of, by association of devotees, they come into, they learn how to take up devotional service.
通过和奉献者们的联谊，他们就开始接受了从事奉爱服务。
So sometimes Krishna arranges opportunities like that, that the Mayavadi, they get the association of a devotee.
有的时候主 Krishna 会安排就 Mayavadi, 假象中人士能够跟奉献者们开始联谊。
Just like maybe the Sankirtan party comes and we do Sankirtan chanting,the Mayavadi is meditating and he becomes attracted to the kirtan.
有时候呢，我们从事 Sankirtan 其中圣名，而那些正在冥想的 Mayavadi, 他们就马上受到吸引了。
So even they may have become liberated, they may be big impersonalists and they've come to the liberation, but they are attracted to chanting Hare Krishna.
即便他们已经解脱了，他们已经是了不起的这个非人格主义者，但是他们，仍然会受到唱诵 Hare Krishna 的吸引。
So they were already liberated, and so then they associate with devotees, and they get a spiritual body, and they start to worship Krishna.
他们虽然已经解脱了，然后因为与奉献者的联谊，所以就得到了灵性的身体，因此便开始崇拜 Krishna.
Even people who they're already liberated, they're in the Brahman, they don't have a material body, but they have their spiritual body, but they're not acting, they're not doing anything.
就是这些非人格主义者，他们已经身处在 Brahman 当中了，他们没有物质的躯体，他们已经有的是灵性的身体。
They still, even they merge into the Brahman, they still have their individual identity.
虽然他们已经完全融入 Brahman 的存在当中，但是他们还是有各自的身份。
And when they see the devotees, they become attracted to join chanting.To do Sankirtan, and then they develop their spiritual body.
一旦他们看到奉献者，他们便加入这些奉献者从事 Sankirtan, 从而慢慢的培养起发展出一具灵性的身体。
So it's not very common, but sometimes it happens like that.
所以这个并不是司空见惯的现象，但是有的时候就确实发生了。
Impersonalists are a real impersonalist. You know, it's very rare they actually get liberation.
非人格主义者，他们非常的罕见，然后他们获得了真正的解脱。
And from those who get real liberation, maybe one of them may become a devotee.
他们已经获得了真实的解脱。这些成千上万的这些非人格主义者当中，也许只有一个才能开始从事奉爱服务。
It proves devotional service is greater than liberation.
这一点就证明了奉献服务要高于解脱。
So liberating souls, they also need the mercy of Krishna, and they get it through the devotees by chanting.
解脱了的灵魂也需要 Krishna 的仁慈，而这是通过奉献者的仁慈而得到的。他们通过念诵就得到了这份仁慈。
So another qualification which we require to actually understand to become liberated, to become self-realized, is we have to give up our false ego.
另外一个。就是获得自我觉悟的，能够得到解脱的资格，就是不要放弃假自我。
Now, when somebody actually understands the Supreme Lord, if we actually understand Krishna properly, then this is very easy to give up the false ego.
一个理解至尊主，理解明白了 Krishna， 正确的理解了 Krishna 的人。就很容易做到。
Sometimes the impersonalists, the Mayavadis, they will criticize the devotees.
有时候非人格主义者 Mayavadi 们会批评奉献者们。
Because they say these devotees, they think the goal is service to Krishna, but they have not understood their real self.
他们说这些奉献者们，他们说他们的目标是服务 Krishna， 可是他们还不明白真正的自我，何谓真正的自我呢？
Because we say, in order to get anywhere, in order to progress, you have to do some devotional service. It's only by some devotional service that you become qualified for some.To progress in spiritual life.
而我们说，为了达到目的，就是如果你要去任何地方，你必须得从事服务，这样你才能有资格取得在灵修生活当中取得进步。
But they cannot understand how we can do devotional service if we're still imperfect, if we're still conditioned.
但是他们不明白，我们仍然受到条件的限制，我们还不完美，怎么能从事就是做奉爱呢？
If we've already done something before, then how can we start it?Once we become perfect, you can do it. But how can you do it before you become perfect?
就是如果你已经达到完美了，那当然你可以从事你想做的事情。但是如果你还不完美的话，那你怎么去做呢？做事呢？
This is difficult for people to understand.
就人们就很难理解。
So they being attracted to devotional service, it helps us to get free from the desire for sense gratification.
受到奉爱服务的吸引，就能够帮助我们摆脱对感官享受感官的欲望。
Even somebody's liberated, they don't want anything material, but they want devotional service.
就一个已经解脱了的人，他们不想要物质的事物，物质的目标，但是他们仍然想要奉爱服务。
Because they're attracted to Krishna, the qualities of Krishna attract them.
因为 Krishna 的品质就吸引了他们。
We want to have reciprocation. We're persons, we're individuals, and we enjoy relationships.
我们想要回报，因为我们是人，我们想要一种关系。
But impersonalists, they say, no, this is only sentimental, this is only your mind, you have to give all this up.
非人格主义说，不，这些你们都是感情用事的，都是心意，必须得把这些放弃掉。Impersonalists
say, we're wrong to put our faith in God.
非人格主义者们声称， 我们把信心放在 Krishna 身上，这是错误的。
They say that we imagine that we have to get the mercy of Krishna. We imagine we have to have association with devotees.
他们说，我们要 Krishna 的仁慈。 我们要跟奉献者联谊，这全都是我们自己心意想象出来的。
And we say that liberation is not as good as devotional service, but they don't agree.
我们说，解脱无法跟奉献服务相媲美，但是这些非人格主义者不赞同这一点。
We say devotional service is how we satisfy the self.
我们说，从事奉献服务才能令自我感觉满足。
But they say, no, you have to realize you're God.
他们说，不，你们应该觉悟，你们才是神。
So they say that you just have to give up false ego.
你们只需要放弃你们的假自我。
Then you can understand your real self.
然后你们就能明白真实的自我。
You don't have to do, they will say you don't have to do devotional service.
他们说你们没必要去从事奉献服务。
But we say, how can you give up false ego if you haven't done devotional service?
然而我们却说， 如果你们不从事奉献服务，怎么能放弃假我呢？
And there are great authorities, great spiritual teachers. They say that it's very easy to give up false ego.
他们说，有一些权威，还有一些灵性的老师，他们很容易就放弃了假自我了。
Just like it's easy to close your eyes, or it's easy to pick a flower in the garden, so it's easy to give up false ego. It's as easy as that.
就像闭上眼睛，或者是从花园当中摘一朵花那么容易。
But somebody who's not a devotee, they will say, no, no, it's not so easy.
就是刚才是那样，就是说，如果有灵性权威就很容易了，就因为奉献服务，奉献者对奉献而言，这很容易的事儿。
No, a non-devotee, somebody who is not a devotee, he will say, to do devotional service, you have to have some ego.
他们声称，你们要从事奉献服务，必须要有自我才可以从事服务。So
how can you do devotional service if you don't have any ego?
如果你们没有自我，你们怎么做服务呢？
So they don't understand Krishna's energy, Krishna's spiritual energy.
他们嗯。 Krishna 的灵性能量。
There's material ego, there's also spiritual ego.
有物质的自我，还有灵性的自我。
So when we take up devotional service, Krishna gives us spiritual ego.
当我们从事服务，接受了服务之后， Krishna 就赐予我们一个自我，灵性的自我。
Spiritual ego is, I am the servant of Krishna.
什么是灵性的自我呢？那就是我是 Krishna 的仆人。
Right, we give up the false ego, the material ego. Material ego, we're thinking, I am the controller, I am the doer.
我要放弃物质的自我，放弃假自我。物质的自我、假自我就认为我是控制者，我是真正的这个实施者。
But spiritual ego is to understand I am his servant.
而灵性的自我是明白我是仆人。
So when we do devotional service, then liberation naturally follows. It's given easily to a devotee.
当我们从事奉献服务的时候，就解脱就很容易的就被赐予给这样的奉献者。
A devotee is not worried about understanding about being being self-realized or satisfaction, finding satisfaction in the self, knowing is not the body, because it's not part of the process of bhakti yoga. It's not important for a devotee.
奉献者并不担心要去自我从自我觉悟，要在自我当中获得满足，或者是明白并非这个躯体。因为这些呢，并不是 bhakti 的一个程序。对于 bhakti 而言，这些不重要。
Yeah, for the devotee, what's important is to develop pure love for Krishna.
对奉献者而言，重要的是发展起对 Krishna 的纯爱。
Devotees are also joyful. They're also happy in their service to Krishna.
奉献者在为 Krishna 做服务当中。
And devotees also have knowledge, and they also have mystic, they also have perfect yoga practice.
奉献者们也同时拥有着知识，他们同时也得到了瑜伽的所有完美境界。
We get all these benefits by doing devotional service, by hearing and chanting about Krishna.
我们通过从事奉献服务，通过聆听、唱诵 Krishna， 得到这一切的好处。
We give the example, just like if you're going to cook and you light a fire. So when you light the fire, it also gets rid of darkness and takes away the cold.
我们打了一个比喻，就好像一个人开始生火做饭，一旦他点燃了火之后。这黑暗就立即驱除掉，并且寒冷也一并驱除了。
The impersonalists, they're just like the people. They just light the fire only to take away the darkness.
非人格主义者们就好像那些只想为了驱除黑暗而生活的人。
But devotees lighting the fire are going to cook.
而奉献者们生火是为了做饭。
When we light the fire, then all the darkness is also taken away by the fire.
当奉献者升起火的时候，黑暗就自然而然地消除了。
So a devotee doesn't worry about these side benefits which come with devotional service.
因此，奉献者们对于从事奉献服务带来的所有这些副产品。这些次要的好处并不在意。
The real goal of devotional service, the final goal is to develop prema, love of God.
从事奉献服务的目标是发展起 prema, 对神的爱。
And that is never sat, love of God is never satisfied. We never have enough. We always want more.
而对 Krishna, 对神的爱 是永不会满足的，是永无厌足的。我们想要越来越多的神爱。
We always want to surrender more. We want to do more service for Krishna. We never think I've done enough.
我们想要越来越多的臣服 Krishna， 为 Krishna 做越来越多的服务。我们从来不觉得自己做的足够了。
So we should be careful. Devotee should never become, oh, I'm satisfied. Now I've done enough. We should never think like that.
我们应当小心，不要已经自非常的满足了，觉得哎，我已经做的不错了。
Devotee always wants to give more to Krishna.
奉献者们就想，给 Krishna 越来越多的给予 Krishna。
So someone may not get devotion to Krishna. They may just simply find satisfaction in their self. They understand they're not the body, and they're satisfied that this is enough for them.
还没有取得对 Krishna 的奉爱的人，他们就仅仅满足于已经觉悟了自我，觉悟到他们并非这个躯体。
So if somebody is happy with that, if they're happy with that, okay, that's up to them. They have that free will.
如果有的人就对此已经感到很快乐，那 OK 了，因为这是他们的自由意志，取决于他们。
So that devotional service is something much more valuable than that kind of happiness.
而奉献服务的快乐，比这种前面所上述的那种沾沾自喜要巨大的多。
But if somebody is happy, they just want to get that kind of, they just want to come to that level, then devotees are saying, okay, we bless you, you stay on that level.
如果有的人对于就是已经取得了自我觉悟，就是达到这个层面就已经满足了，奉献者会祝福他们，祝福你，你愿意的话，你就留在那个层面好了。
Now, somebody may be doing their duty in the material life, and they're performing their duty very carefully. They think, this is my responsibility, I have to do this.
Oh, 我必须得要做这个，履行我的责任。
So, that's also a kind of devotional service.
这也是一种奉献服务。
Because they have to have some devotion to do that, to do their duty.
因为我要想履行好他们的职责的话，也必须有一些奉爱才能做好。
So even you're doing karma, you see, you have to have some devotion. There's going to be some devotion there.
如果是单纯的从事 karma, 那也必须得有一些奉爱的成分元素。
So in everything.We see some devotion. There's some devotion there.
我们看到，就是无论是任何的方法，都必须有一些奉爱的元素成分。
So we have to purify our consciousness, then we can actually understand what is real happiness.
我们必须要首先净化。知觉才能明白何谓真正的快乐。
we see that for the impersonalist to be successful, they also have to have some devotion.
我们看到非人格主非人就这些人非人格主义者，他们要取得成功，也得有奉爱的成分。
So, doing one's duty according to the Vedas, this is the external form of devotional service.
根据韦达经，履行固定职责，这是奉献服务的外在形式。
And the result is you get satisfaction. You find peace of mind, satisfaction in the self.
那它的结果是内心的平和，并且对自我感到满足。
They didn't do hearing and chanting, but they had some devotion. They did their duty with some devotion for the Supreme.
他们不从事于聆听和唱诵，但是呢，他们也对于主怀着一些奉爱之情。
They didn't know who is actually the Supreme. They have no idea.
他们不知道谁是至尊者，他们对这一点他们没有概念。
But they have some idea that, okay, we have to do this for the higher purpose, satisfy the God. Whoever the God is, we want to please him, do our duty.
他们只是知道，哦，为了更高的目标，我必须得这样去做。他们并不，他们知道也应该去满足神，取悦神，不管是谁神。
So they get satisfaction.
所以他们也得到了一些快乐和满足。
They understand they're not the body.
他们明白他们不是这个躯体。
They're freed of material desires.
他们免除了物质的欲望。
But the devotee who does hearing and chanting and practices remembering about the Lord, then they get the real result of bhakti.
但是从事于聆听、唱诵、意念主的人得到了 bhakti 的真正的好处。
They get prema, they get love of God.
他们获得了 prema, 神爱。
So sometimes these people who understand they're not the body, sometimes they also take shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna.
他们有时候这些已经意识到了、觉悟到了他们并非这个躯体的人，他们也开始脱离于 Krishna 的莲花足。
They're already liberated, so it's.If they become attracted to Krishna's lotus feet, it's not difficult for them to take up devotional service.
Because they have already been liberated, so once they are attracted to Krishna's lotus feet, they start to perform service. It's a very easy thing.
Because they have no material attachment.
Because they have no material attachment.
But if they become attached to Krishna, then they can take up devotional service.
一旦他们已经开始依附 Krishna， 就能够从事、接受、接纳奉爱服务了。
So, but this doesn't happen very often.
但是这种情况并不是很常见的。
So everybody has an opportunity for devotional service. Doesn't matter who they are. Devotional service is open for everyone.
人人都有机会从事奉献服务，奉献服务的大门是向所有人敞开着的。
They say just like everybody can have a bath in the Ganga, nobody's restricted. We don't tell anybody, no, you cannot take bath in the Ganga. Everyone can go and take bath in the Ganga.
就像每个人都有权利去恒河沐浴，我们不能限，我们不限制。某人说不行，你不能进入恒河沐浴，不是这样的。
Yeah. In the same way, everyone can do devotional service.
同样的方式，每一个人都可以从事奉爱服务。
So everybody can qualify for the pure, if they want to do pure devotional service, they can also take it up. If they just need to get the mercy of Krishna, which comes through the devotees.
他只需要透过奉献者取得Krishna的仁慈。
So that when they do devotional service, they will experience real happiness, the happiness in serving Krishna.
所以一旦他们开始做服务的话，就能品尝到服务Krishna从中得来的真实的快乐。
We get that there's the happiness of the senses which are used in the service of Krishna. They experience the pleasure of giving service to Krishna.
当我为Krishna做服务的时候，就是感官能够品尝到因为给予Krishna提供服务而得来的快乐。
In devotional service, the experience is very real. You can experience the happiness. The devotee who is doing the service, he experiences the pleasure of serving Krishna.
从事奉献服务的奉献者可以品尝到从服务而来的真正的快乐。
And he can experience also Krishna and his relationship with Krishna, how Krishna is pleased to see the devotee serving him. The devotee understands, I am Krishna's servant. And he will want to take up a particular service for Krishna. Just like sometimes devotee will make flower garlands for Krishna, or he will massage Krishna's lotus feet.
有的奉献者就非常的钟爱为Krishna穿花环，有的奉献者非常钟爱就为Krishna按摩Krishna的莲花足。So
then Krishna also attracts the devotee. Krishna displays many wonderful features to attract the devotee.
Krishna就会对这样的奉献者非常满意，就会向这样的奉献者展示他的特征，以便吸引他。
So the happiness of devotional service, there's nothing to equal to it, nothing to compare to it. So a pure devotee, one who is doing in Krishna consciousness, he's not only understood himself, but he's also understood his relationship with Krishna. We know what particular service Krishna wants us to do. We're inspired to serve Krishna in a particular way. Okay, so but if somebody is doing impersonal meditation and even they get to samadhi, then that samadhi is the happiness there and the pleasure there is very small and very insignificant.
但是从事冥想的非人格主义者，即便已经进入了samadhi神定，这样得来的快乐也非常的渺小和微不足道。
They stop their process, their samadhi is to stop the mind. So there's nothing there in the mind, to make the mind empty.
他们的samadhi就是停止心意的活动，就是他们的心意那时候是一种空的状态。
But a devotee, he's meditating, we're also meditating, we have the Lord in our mind.
奉献者也是冥想，但是他们心意里装的是主。
So we experience, it's our trance, our samadhi is something very different from the impersonalist.
我们的体验就是和非人格主义者的体验是截然不同的。Right,
for the impersonalists, they stop their ego, they stop all the senses, they stop the mind, everything stopped.
非人格主义者会停止自我，停止感官活动，停止心意。So
they cannot understand anything because they're totally in samadhi, they've stopped the mind, they've stopped all the senses, so there's no real happiness there.
他们处在他们的神定samadhi状态中的时候呢，那时候没有什么真实的快乐。So their
goal is just to give up the suffering, the pain of material life.
他们的目标仅仅是为了停止物质生活的痛苦。
So their samadhi, their concept of samadhi is without any real pleasure.
他们对于samadhi的概念就是没有什么快乐。
But for a devotee, there is great pleasure in samadhi because all their senses and mind, everything is linked to the service of Krishna.
然而，奉献者的samadhi当中的快乐，有感官的快乐、心的快乐，而这些都跟Krishna是紧紧相关的。Of course,
the impersonalists, they argue, they say no, they say when we're in samadhi, they said we understand the Brahman is like the head is like the fountain head of everything comes from the Brahman, and we are in that one Brahman from which everything comes.
但是非人格主义者们，他们马上他们的就会争议说，不是的，当我们处在 Brahman 当中的时候，我们能够觉悟到这个 Brahman 是一切万事万物的源泉。
So that may be true. Brahman is like that. Everything comes from the Brahman.
这也许是真的，因为确实万事万物是来源于 Brahman。But the
meditator, the one in samadhi, his senses are not functioning, so he cannot experience anything.
但是当他们处在samadhi当中的时候，他们的感官已经 停止了自己的功能，所以他们已经无法去体验到快乐。So they
say Brahman is everywhere, it's always present and it's everywhere. So why isn't everybody liberated?
他们说，Brahman是遍存万有的，是永存永在的。那为什么不是每个人都已经解脱了呢？
Everybody's not liberated. Very rare people are liberated.
我们知道，确实，解脱是很罕见的。
So impersonal samadhi does not free one. It does not help us to get free from material existence.
非人格主义的 samadhi 不能使人摆脱真正的物质存在。
Because you have no power to act, you stop everything, you're not doing anything.
因为没有活动的力量，你已经停止了一切了。
But when we do devotional service, we're engaged in activities, we're using our senses, everything in the service of the Lord.
当我们从事服务、奉献服务的时候呢，是处于一种积极活跃的状态，我们的感官都是在服务着。
So our samadhi is devotional samadhi.
所以我们的samadhi是一种奉爱的samadhi。
We know clearly what we're doing, who we're serving Krishna, and we're meditating on Krishna.
我们知道我们在自己在做着什么事，我们在服务的是谁。
So the Vaishnavas develop love for Krishna, and we can feel how the whole body becomes purified, becomes liberated.
他们爱 Krishna 的时候，他们感受到他们躯体上上下下都已经进化了。
We should understand that we also have a spiritual mind and spiritual senses.
我们应当明白，我们也有灵性的心意，灵性的感官。
So within the material body, within the material mind, there's spiritual senses, a spiritual mind.
在物质的躯体，物质的感官。 之内有着灵性的感官，灵性的心意。And
as we become purified, then that spiritual mind and spiritual senses they perform all the activities of the body and senses.
在进化了的状态下，感官、灵性的感官、灵性的心意在从事着这个活动。
So in this way we experience it, the power of pure devotional service.
就这样，我们就体验着奉爱服务的力量所在。Okay,
we'll stop. Ask if there's any questions.
好，接下来我们来回答问题。
看到了，但还是您来读吧。好，第一个问题是Chitra Mataji的问题，感谢翻译。您今天讲到修行的方法是服务 Krishna， 修行的目标也是 Krishna， 就像唱诵既是手段也是目标。我的问题是。 我所服务的新奉献者连移一年多了，他明白个体灵魂和至尊主的关系，也知道念诵曼陀罗的重要性，但是还是不能规律的念诵，甚至两圈。我该怎么做呢？保持什么样的心态呢？谢谢您。是，Chakshishramadaji said, you mentioned
in the lecture. Devotional service is a method is also the goal. Her question is that there's a new fatty in her group. She knew the relationship between Jiva and the Supreme Lord and also the importance of chanting mantra, but still she cannot chant regularly, even two rounds. So what should she do? And what should be her mentality?
Well, her mentality should be that she's suffering due to her karma, due to past reactions. She's no attraction for the holy name. So she should try to do some service, try to do more service, try to, if she can contribute financially to the activities there, or maybe she can help to do the shopping, physical activities. She has to take up these kind of activities, cutting, cleaning, these kind of service. By doing service, then she will develop some more piety, and this will qualify her for chanting the holy name. If she can also serve devotees, then the devotees who are chanting the holy name, they can bless her. Yeah, she needs to get rid of her past karma, and she needs to do more pious, she needs to get some, do some devotional service, some activities in relation to devotees. It will give her the qualification for devotional service. Right, to take up devotional service, we need to get the blessings of devotees. And we get the blessings of devotees by doing some service for them. So you have to see if is she willing to cooperate to do that. Some people may not be willing. Does she hear? Does she come and listen to the classes? Does she read the books? She doesn't chant. She doesn't want to chant. Does she take part in kirtan? Do you have kirtan? Sometimes people need more kirtan in order to chant. Let her listen to kirtan as much as she can. If you let her play the kirtan tapes and listen to kirtan, watch videos of kirtan going on, and if she takes part in the kirtan, then she will gradually start to chant more the holy name.
Kirtan的录音，让他来看Kirtan的视频，让他参与到Kirtan当中，这样呢，他能逐渐的开始念诵圣名。
Otherwise, you may just have to accept that she will never chant more than two rounds. That's her own level. That's as far as she can go. She cannot chant more.
否则的话，你就只能接受她，她的念诵超不过两圈这个事实了，就是她就超不过两圈。
So she can never be initiated. She can never be a proper devotee.
如果是这样的话，她永远得不到启迪，永远不能成为一个，就是恰当的奉献者。
She has some devotion, but very limited.
她有一点点奉爱，但是这个奉爱非常有限。
Okay. Hare Krishna.Shai Gawente.
Shai Gawente. Krishna Mahi Mataji. Hare Krishna Dimbai Guru. 请教 Guru, 韦达经的人格化身叫什么名字？感恩 Guru.
What's the name of the personification of Vedas?
Their name is the Vedas personified.
他的名字就叫做韦达经的人格化身。就人格化的韦达经。
对。
好的。Good day.刚才那个叉七叔马达基，接着他那个问题，他问一下，他说，我应该保持什么样的心态对这样的事情，这种情况
？Well, we have to appreciate everyone has their own limitations, but we just be encouraging them, encourage the lady that she likes to come, she likes to chant two rounds, and she likes to take part in some activities. So we have to appreciate, you know, she has some devotion.
我们需要欣赏，保持一种欣赏的心态，因为人人都有各自的局限性。我们要鼓励她，这个女士她能来，能够念两圈，能够参加一些活动，就她，我们要欣赏她这种奉爱。
Which is a lot better than people who don't chant at all, and many people have no interest at all.But at least this lady has some interest.
这比那些一点都不念的人好得多，因为有的人就是没有丝毫的兴趣。
好的，那我们下一个问题。智敏吧大姐，顶拜敬爱的 Guru Maharaja。感谢翻译。派书是圣帕普帕德在派，传教也是 Krishna 给的服务的机会。但是我在做这些服务的时候，却感受到很大的压力，我该怎么办呢？这是我自己的业力吗？我该如何放下一切，交托给 Krishna？
Said that book distribution is Prabhupada's distributing books. Preaching is also the chance that Krishna gives the chance to do service. But when the Mataji is doing these services, she felt great pressure. So she asked, what should she do? Is it by her own karma? Should she surrendered everything to Krishna, let Krishna take care of everything.
When we take up service, you have to expect there will be some resistance from Maya. Maya will trouble us.
当我们开始从事服务的时候，我们就要有这种心理准备，就是玛雅会抵抗我们的服务，玛雅会给我们的服务造成一些麻烦。
Maya wants to see, are you really serious to be a devotee? Are you really serious to do this service for Krishna?
妈呀，就想看，您是不是真的想要做一名奉献者呢？您是真的在为 Krishna 做这项服务吗？
If just because you get a little pressure, you get a little difficulty, are you going to give up? No, you have to be very determined. You're going to fight Maya, so you have to expect there will be some resistance. There will be some opposition.
您现在有了压力，有了麻烦，那您是不是准备就放弃了呢？您得下定决心跟玛雅作战，您得有这种心理的准备，您得期望着玛雅会有一些抗拒，玛雅确实会给您提供一些麻烦。
You declare war on the material energy. You make a war with material energy.Material energy will fight back.
您现在是在向物质能量宣战，所以物质能量呢，它也会还击。
Okay. So you have to be determined. You want to do things like preaching and book distribution. You have to be very...determined. You have to be very, use your intelligence, how to do this, how to fight Maya, how to defeat the Maya.
您得要下定决心，现在您现在在传播，那您就得，您现在要派书，您就得有特别大的决心，并且要运用自己的智力去跟Maya作战。
Okay, 下一个问题。
好的，下一个问题，杨乃莲马德吉，顶拜咕噜，顶拜翻译，顶拜所有的奉献者。请问咕噜，爱是灵魂与生俱来的吗？是不是因为没有爱才来到了这个物质世界？是因为没有爱才履行不好所有的职责吗？感恩咕噜的解答，顶拜您的莲花足。
So, Yang Gai Lian Mataji is paying obeisance to you and every devotees. She asks, is love inherent from the birth? Is that, that without love we came to this material world because we don't have love? Is that we cannot carry out all our duties very nicely?Is due to lack of love. So.
Well, everyone has got love. The problem is we're giving the love to other things. We're meant to love Krishna, but instead of loving Krishna, we love our body, we love our dog, we love our car, and so many other things.
人人都拥有爱，就是问题就在于我们现在爱的是其他的事物，我们没有爱 Krishna， 我们爱这个躯体，爱狗儿，爱这个车，轿车，爱的是别的事情。
We're not using the love for Krishna. We're lovingIt's not really love, it's more lust. The opposite of, when the love is not used properly, then it is called lust.
问题就在于我们没有将爱放置于 Krishna 身上。就当这种情况出现的时候，实际上这称为色欲。这个并不是爱，而是色欲。
So the love for Krishna awakens the more we hear about Krishna.
We 越多的聆听 Krishna, 对 Krishna 的爱 也就会越来越被唤醒。
嗯哼。So yeah, we come here to this world because we don't love Krishna. We give up the love for Krishna. We wanted to love independently of Krishna.
您说的对，就是我们来到这个物质世界，是因为我们不爱 Krishna， 所以来到这个物质世界。我们想独立于 Krishna， 就是自己独立的去爱。
We became competitor with Krishna. Why I should love Krishna? I should love myself. We forget we are part of Krishna. So love of Krishna includes also love of ourself, not the body.But the spiritual self.
I Krishna 也包含了爱我们自己，但却不是爱我们这个躯体，而是来爱我们真实的自我。
Okay, 下一个问题。Haribo。
下一个问题，他是虾马，来自虾马，虾马，顶拜 Guru Maharaj， 感恩您，感谢主持人，觉悟自我，只是奉献服务的开始。我们经典一直强调觉悟自我，我们的觉悟自我与非人格有什么区别吗
？Yes, there's a difference. The impersonalists, they just want to understand that they're not the body.They don't understand the Supreme Lord.
有区别，非人格主义者他们的就想要去觉悟到他们不是这个躯体，他们并不理解，并不明白至尊主。
Impersonalist realization is to understand only I am Brahman.
非人格觉悟就是觉悟。我是 Brahman.
But they don't understand that there's a supreme Brahman and we have a relationship with him.
但是风爱的觉悟是觉悟到还有一位至尊的 Brahman 存在着，而且我们还跟这个至尊的 Brahman 有着关系。
So real self-realization, devotee self-realization is to understandNot only we're Brahman, but we have a relationship with the Supreme Brahman, and we want to understand more about that relationship.
因此，真正的自我觉悟，奉爱的自我觉悟，是觉悟到存在着一位至尊的 Brahman. 我们和这位至尊的 Brahman 之间存在着一种关系。我们要越来越多的了解我们二之间的关系。
We want to act on that level of self-realization.
并且就在这种自我觉悟的基础之上采取行动。
Okay, 下一个问题。
下一个问题，老贝，怎样才能放下物质欲望？
By serving Krishna, by having spirit, links in the yu wang, we have the spiritual desires.
通过服务 Krishna, 我们有灵性的欲望。
We have to do more service for Krishna. We have to develop the desire to do service for Krishna. Then we'll forget about material desires.
我们需要从事越来越多的、更多的服务，需要培养灵性的欲望。一旦培养了服务 Krishna 欲望，就会放下物质愿望。
Of course.That's easy to say, not so easy to do, right?
当然了，其实说说容易，但是做起来就不容易了。
So, you need to get good association with devotees. You need to have nice activities of Krishna consciousness.
您需要与一个奉献者很好的联谊，需要在 Krishna 知觉中发展非常好的活动。
OK, 下一个问题。
下一个智敏，没有想放弃，没有气绝，没有想放弃，就是想知道，压力是来自于自己的业力还是心意？下定决心用自己的智性与Maya作战吗？还是祈祷 Krishna 的帮助？
Yali is in the mind. Stress is in the mind, is it?
Yes, yes. From karma or mind?
Yes, it's in the mind.
是的，压力是在心里当中的。
The mind is thinking, oh, this is, oh, I'm so much trouble, so many different, oh.And another person is in a much worse situation and they're not worried about it, but because we're in a little difficulty, we get very worried, but somebody else is much worse and they're not worried about it. It's the mind, the difference, how our mind is seeing everything.
当我们遇到一点点麻烦的时候，我们就想，哦，这么多麻烦。哦，这个哦，那个，但是另外一个他的那个处在更糟糕的境况当中的人，他一点也不担心，而我们有一点点麻烦，我们就开始特别的担心，所以这是来自于心意当中的，而另外一个就是境况很糟糕的人，因为他看待事物是一种方，另外一种方式看待事物，所以他根本就不在乎。Next,、Radha Nanda, Hare Krishna, 深深顶拜敬爱的圣 Guru Maharaja, 请问如何消除优越感和拥有感？这些也是感官享乐吗？How to get rid of this? The sense that we are much better than others, and the sense of proprietorship. Is it the sense gratification? She asked.
The sense of being better than others, and the sense of proprietorship.
Yes.
Okay. So, sense of.Proprietorship is forgetfulness of our relationship with Krishna. That Krishna is the proprietor, we're thinking this belongs to me, we're not thinking belongs to Krishna. We should always remember we came to this world with nothing and we will leave with nothing. So, what is nothing is actually ours. Krishna gives us some things for some time.But not eternally. Then we have to leave everything here.
Krishna 就在一段时间之内给了我们这些事物，但这些不是永恒的，最终还得放弃。
So, like this, we should understand Krishna, we're not the proprietor, and then the sense of being better than others.That is due to our some kind of pride. So we have to develop humility. We have to think of ourselves is very low and fallen.
这种优越感是源于骄傲。我们应该变谦卑，就感觉自己很低下，很堕落。
We should think whatever good qualities are in me, it is the mercy of my spiritual master.
我们应当这样想，无论我身上有什么好的品质，这都是因为我的灵性导师给的。
But I am most fallen and sinful, hopeless.
但是我是最为堕落，最非常的罪恶。也没有什么希望。
We want to offer all respects to others.
我们希望向他人致敬。
And never be anxious to get respect for herself.
不期待别人尊敬自己。
Lord Chaitanya has taught us this in the Shikshastika.
主柴根尼亚在八训规第三条就教导我们这一点。
So we have to remember this, that we are nothing without the mercy of our spiritual master.
我们要时刻牢记，没有灵性导师的仁慈，我们是一无是处的。
Okay, Hare Krishna.
The next.
Yeah.
Jayanti.David Darcy， 顶拜 Gurudev， 请问您，灵魂除了极乐，其他的负面情绪都不是灵魂的本性了吗？比如说忏悔。
忏悔。Well。
忏悔。
The what lament what is it? 忏悔 lament。
Lament regret
yeah, yeah.
repent。
Uh-huh. Yeah. Well.Look, there's also that in, when it's in relation to Krishna, then that's spiritual. Just like we said, there's spiritual senses and spiritual mind. So the spiritual mind, there is also this lamenting.
如果是跟 Krishna 有关的，那就是灵性的。就在课上已经讲过。有灵性的感官，灵性的心意，所以如果是跟Krishna 相关的，也有灵性上的悲叹，灵性上的忏悔。
So these feelings are there. There are feelings on the material platform, and there are feelings on the spiritual platform.
因此就是有灵物质层面上的这些情绪，还有灵性层面的情绪。
The spiritual platform, it's all the feelings are all in relation to Krishna and Krishna's service.
在灵性层面上，这一切呢，全都是跟 Krishna 有关系，与对 Krishna 的服务息息相关的。
But on the material platform, they're all in relation to the body, the material body, the material mind.
在物质层面上，这些情绪是跟我们的躯体、物质的躯体、物质心意息息相关。
Okay. 还有问题？
没有了。三点半的就是没有了吧？
Okay.
Okay. 稍等，我这还有问题。我转过来。
有时候能念几十圈，这是心意的波动吗？该怎么去控制呢？
Well, how to be regular in chanting 16 rounds. Sometimes you chant more and sometimes you chant less. How to regulate?
Sometimes he chants 16 rounds, sometimes dozens of rounds, like 50, 40, like
yeah. Is it too? Yeah. So, how to regulate? Well, it's good. It's good if you chant more rounds, but you don't want to chant less than 16 rounds.
唱几十圈，念几十圈是非常好的，但是不应该少于16圈。
Yeah, you have to have some minimum every day. You have to chant some minimum rounds every day. You have to chant, and the minimum number of rounds you have to chant is 16 rounds, right?
但是每天应该至少念诵16圈。
You shouldn't have a day when you chant less than 16 rounds. Some days you can chant more, okay, no problem. But don't chant less.
有的时候能念几十圈，很好，但是呢，不能就是每有一天就少于16圈。
We make a vow. You have to make a vow. You have to just control, be determined that this is your standard. You're not going to sleep until you finish your 16 rounds.
我们要发下誓言，你要下定决心。我们的目标就是，这是我们的目标。如果不完成16圈，就不睡觉。
Not going to eat till I finish my 16 rounds.
在完成我的16圈之前，我就不吃饭了。
Not going to look at my handphone and my emails until I finish my 16 rounds.
除非我念完我16圈，否则我不看我的手机，我也不看我的电子邮件。
We have to make some kind of vow. We have to be determined to finish the 16 rounds.
我们要发下这誓言，就一定要下定决心完成自己的16圈。还有问题？下一个问题。 Do you want to continue or?
Go ahead. Yeah, go ahead.
Dingbai Kelly Lalita. Dingbai Guru 的莲花族，请教Guru，小孩子的灵魂心意处在愚昧形态中吗？ Krishna 怎样在小孩子的心意里面指导他？
Krishna Zamana 在小孩子的。
How can Krishna guide
the
child?
Well, Krishna is the guiding from the heart as the super soul, right? From the super soul comes knowledge, remembrance, and forgetfulness. So this is there also in the child. Haribo?
Haribo. Krishna is in the heart. Krishna, 他以超灵的身份，就是佛家梵高说，记忆、知识、遗忘都来源于我，所以以超灵他在指导着小孩子。From the
very birth, super soul is there.
从一出生了。 就是超灵就开始指导了。
So Krishna is directing the wanderings of all living entities, not only children, the animals also, the super soul is there in the heart.
就是超灵，他指导着不仅仅是小孩子，所有生物体的漫游。 而且指导着动物们的活动。The 方 Ishvari Devadasi 顶拜 Gurudev 问个题外的问题，我的 Tusi 树每天拿到门外，晚上拿回屋里，昨天忘拿回来，我在想以后就把 Tusi 放外面可以吗？感恩 Gurudev。
Yes, you can keep the Tulsi outside if so long as it's not, the wind is not too strong, so long as that, you know, the weather is not too cold, Tulsi needs to get sunlight, but if you like to leave it outside all night as well, okay, no problem.
如果您希望就是一整夜把 Tulsi 放在外面，那就只要是风不太大，室外的温度也不是特别冷，可以的，因为 Tulsi 是需要阳光。
Don't forget her. You put her outside, don't forget her. You still have to take care of her. You have to worship her. You have to offer obeisances. You have to pour water.
但是不要把她放在外面就忘了，你还得照顾她，崇拜她，顶拜她，给她浇水。The next one is from Rajendra Prabhu. 感谢 Maharaj. 翻译主持人，做风爱服已经解脱了，我们现在尝试做风爱服是否属于解脱呢？就是 there are many, 是的，如果属于的话，怎么没感觉到解脱呢？还在想着为解脱奋斗终身呢？怀着风爱，怀着物质欲望做风爱服，属于混合的风爱服，是否也解脱了呢？还是走在解脱的路上呢？总而言之，哪怕念一句 Hare Krishna 都已经解脱了吗？谢谢。So you mentioned that we, since we are doing devotional service, we are already liberated.But now we are endeavoring to do devotional service. Is that also counted as liberation? If it is, why? I don't feel this liberation. And I'm thinking that I will endeavoring to get liberation for my whole life. This is my...
If you do devotional service without falling down, then you're liberated. But if you do devotional service 1 minute and then you're not doing devotional service another minute, if you're all the time one way, another way, up and down, sometimes you serve Krishna, sometimes not, then you're not liberated.
如果就是从不堕落的从事奉献服务那就是解脱了。如果前一分钟还做奉献服务，下一秒钟就不做服务了，或者是，在这方面做服务，那方面不做服务，或者是我们的奉献服务起起落落的，一会儿服务一会儿不服务，这就不是解脱了。So, he also asked is that.Mixed devotional service is also liberated
Mixed devotional service means devotional service mixed with material desires, with the mode of passion and with the mode of ignorance. Is that liberated? No.
怀着物质欲望从事于奉爱服，那是因为就是掺杂着激情属性和愚昧属性在从事风爱服务，那么这个是解脱吗？不是。Also, is that chanting one Hare Krishna is already liberated?
Yes, but there's quality in chanting Hare Krishna.You're chanting one Hare Krishna without offense, with pure devotion, that is liberation.
是的，唱诵一句 Hare Krishna 已经解脱了， 但是看那个唱 Hare Krishna 的品质如何，如果是怀着冒犯的，不是纯粹的风爱，纯粹的风爱的念诵就不是解脱，如果是没有冒犯的纯粹的 念诵是解脱。
还有
还有啊，下一个 Shamasaki Hare Krishna 感恩 Guru。 对，翻译主持人，我的问题是奉爱服务是最快乐的，可我有时候在小组联谊看到奉献者都很高兴，可我却充满焦虑，感觉没有缓解我灵性的渴望，我该怎么办呢？是我的服务不够纯粹吗？还是被假我迷惑了呢？
Maybe your anxiety is in relation to Krishna, because you're organizing the service, you're arranging the program, so you have to be a bit in anxiety. You have to be in anxiety that, or the people coming, is the prasadam ready, everything, is everything okay? So you accept some anxiety on behalf of Krishna.
So, 您的焦虑呢？你也许是跟 Krishna 相关的，因为您在忙着服务 Krishna， 在忙着做出安排，在照顾着这些来的人，所以您就担心着，哦 ，Prasad 够不够啊？是不是一切都 OK 啊？所以您是代表 Krishna 在焦虑着。
So there's anxiety in the spiritual platform, also. Don't worry, you're doing nice.
不要担心，您做得很棒。
还有问题吗？
还有一个 ，Sita Rani Devadasi， 比麦古尔德根 ，Raghunath Das Goswami 坐在 Radhakund 的冥想时 ，Krishna 担心他被老虎伤害来保护他，请问 Guru Dev。Krishna 为什么不以超灵在老虎的内心指导老虎离开这样的展，离开呢？这样的展是在怎么理解您理解的？明白您。
Krishna. Well, Krishna likes to reciprocate with his devotees. He likes to give service to his devotees. So Krishna sometimes arranges like that.
回应奉献者，回报奉献者，跟奉献者交流。Krishna 想要服务奉献者，所以这是 Krishna 的安排。
Yeah, Krishna is there in the heart of the tiger. He could also, why doesn't he just tell the tiger to leave the devotee? He can do that, but he likes to also come and serve the devotee. He likes to give service to the devotee.
您说的对 ，Krishna 在老虎的心里头可以。指导老虎走开，但是 Krishna 喜欢来，他喜欢服务奉献者。
Okay, Hare
Krishna. Another question. 乐逍遥，顶拜 Guru， 您好，我今早碰到我一个人，他也是学奉爱瑜伽的。他说，我们永远都不会回到灵魂世界，因为我们不完美。他说有的灵性导师是自封的，他这么说对吗？为什么
灵性老师是封的？
自封的 self claimed
self what
self claimed some spiritual teacher they declare that they are spiritual teachers self-authorized, self-declared.
Mm-hmm.